Yo, what is up, guys? So for today, I'm bringing you Destiny 2. Now, this is going to be a really weird video because I haven't done one like this in a while, or ever, actually, now that I think about it. But I wanted to make this video because I've been hearing a lot from content creators, streamers, just a bunch of people saying that Season of Dawn is bigger or has more content than, like, Warmind or, like, Season of Opulence. And I don't know why, but I just cannot really agree with that sentiment, especially with Warmind specifically, because although Warmind was not the best DLC, it was better than Curse of Osiris for sure it was, but I still cannot agree with that Season of Dawn is bigger than like Warmind or the past seasons we've had. So I wanted to make this video, and I want to do it as like objectively as possible, like neutral. Like, I don't want to show any like emotion about it, because it wouldn't be fair if, like, while I'm reading off the Season of Dawn stuff, I'm like, well, this only has this, this, and this. And then like Warmind, I'm like, so this had this, this. Like, I don't want to do that. That's very disingenuous. I want to do it like as precise as possible. That way the facts can stand by themselves. So I'm going to be doing this from like a list perspective. I wrote this all yesterday down. I was like looking up how, like, all the information that was like available. So if I am missing a few things, let me know in the comments below. This is not a thing to attack Season of Dawn. I just want to like actually state like what's real and what's not, because I, like, in my opinion, I don't think Season of Dawn is bigger than Warmind or like Season of Opulence, for example. So we're going to go with Season of Dawn first, and then Warmind, and then Season of Opulence, because I already know people are going to be like, well, it's not fair that you're comparing Warmind, that was like a big DLC, to Season of Dawn, which is a small DLC. Well, then it's like, okay, then cool, I can definitely compare it to Season of Dawn because it was a season. So the first thing I'm going to say about Season of Dawn is, and this is one that the other DLCs do not have, is the Battle Pass. So with the Battle Pass, you have different bonuses like EXP and currency bonuses, material and currency drops like world materials, infusion materials, glimmer packages. You have two shaders, an emblem, one transmat effect, one finisher, one exotic ghost, two weapon ornaments, one exotic ornament, and one exotic emote. You have the Virtuous Armor ornament from like, what is it, level 60 and above. You have the sundial armor with stats that are above 60. You got the seasonal exotic, the legendary engrams and exotic engrams, and then you have bright engrams after every 5 levels. You also get a number of packages that are 100 bright dust each. I do not know in total how much they are off the top of my head, but you do get like, I think, 3 or 4. For the campaign missions, you do end up getting 2 missions, if I remember correctly. If I'm wrong, let me know in the comments below, but I'm pretty sure it's 2. You get no new planet, but you do get a new area, which is the Sundial Spire. For world drops, you do get 6 returning weapons, but no new shader or armor. And we get a total of 5 new exotics, 3 new world exotics, and then the 2 being Devil's Ruin with 1 mission, and the Bastion quest, which is a community puzzle with an emblem and 19 lore cards. Now, for the first thing we're going to be talking about, aside from all the things I just talked about, is the sundial. So the sundial is an activity that came with Season of Dawn. It comes with 15 weapons, 8 being new and 7 being old weapons. And you roughly had around 2 weeks to collect all the weapons, because they had the first weapons, or the first four in 1 week. And then I think next week was, or the following week was, the next set of weapons, which meant you can get all of them. You ended up getting new emblems and shaders from the sundial. The armor is the same as the battle pass. This is not a negative or a positive, I just wanted to point it out. And for the activity itself, you ended up having 3 different rooms with unique mechanics and a boss room with 4 bosses that had different attacks. Bounties are also available at the obelisk to get weapons, and running sundial can net you 1 to 4 weapons depending where you are in your battle pass. For the Vanguard, we ended up getting Forsaken armor coming back, and we ended up getting a new shader, emblem, and ritual weapon. Crucible is basically the same thing. We had returning armor from Forsaken, a new shader, emblem, and ritual weapon. For Gambit and Gambit Prime, we had no new armor and new shader, emblem, and ritual weapon. And when I say no new armor, I mean the armor's been there since the beginning of Gambit and Gambit Prime. No faction rallies, no Trials of the Nine. For Iron Banner, we have an armor set that is returning from Vanilla Destiny 2 and Season of Opulence, and we did end up getting a new shader and emblem. No new raid or raid lair, and no new strikes. So I'm gonna tally up all of them and then just do it like this is for Season of Opulence and this is for so on and so forth. That way we can actually see at the end, I can like have it all neatly and nice. So now that I'm done with Season of Opulence, let's go up to Warmind. Now, Warmind had three story missions. Now, you can argue that it was more than three because we had the two strikes. I'm going to be generous and say it was two, or it was three, because the other two were just strikes. So we ended up getting a new planet with one armor, 10 weapons, and shaders and emblems. We ended up getting a few world drops. We got 7 new weapons, 3 shaders, 1 armor set for each class if you had the PS4. For exotics, in total we had 15 new world exotics. We had the Whisper mission that took roughly around 3 weeks to get the exotic ship and the catalyst. 3 exotic quests being Sleeper Simulant, which had multiple quest steps, Polaris Lance with the catalyst having multiple quest steps, and Worldline Zero needing you to collect 45 data fragments. We had Escalation Protocol, 3 weapons that would take either 3 weeks or 1 week depending on which boss was up, and a total of 5 weeks to get all the armor. We ended up getting ships, ghosts, shaders, and emblems from Escalation Protocol, and then 5 different bosses with different attacks, designs, and mechanics. For the Vanguard, we ended up getting armor ornaments, which was basically a reskin of the year 1 vanilla skin. 4 weapons, a ghost, shader, sparrow, and an exotic ship. For Crucible, we ended up having armor ornaments again, reskin of the vanilla skin from Destiny 1. 4 weapons and Redrick's Claymore, a shader, few emblems, and an exotic ghost. Now for faction rallies, we ended up having Dead Orbit with armor ornaments for the vanilla skin, Eye of Another World ornament, 3 reskinned weapons, and shaders and emblems. For New Monarchy, we had the armor ornaments with the Crest of Alfi Lupi ornament, 3 reskinned weapons, and shaders and emblems. And for Future War Cult, we ended up having armor ornaments for the vanilla skin, the Knucklehead Radar ornament, 3 reskinned weapons, shaders, and emblems. We had Trials of the Nine, which was a reskin of the armor from vanilla. We ended up getting 3 new weapons, and then shaders and exotic ghosts. Iron Banner, we had a completely new redesign of the vanilla skin, 6 new weapons, and then shaders, emblems, ghosts, ships, and a sparrow. We ended up getting the Raid Lair, Spire of Stars, which gave us 2 new weapons, a reskinned armor, and a reskinned armor ornament, shaders, and an exotic emote. And for strikes, we had the Will of a Thousands, which would net you Transmat Effect and emblems. We had Strange Terrain, which would give you a rocket launcher and emblems, and Insight Terminus, that would net you Sniper Rifle and emblems if you had the PS4. Now, last but not least, we have Season of Opulence. Now, this one unfortunately did not have a campaign. No new planet, but it did have a new area, which was the Tribute Hall. We had no world drops, but we had 7 exotics in total. 3 of them being the Bad Juju questline with the Mini Dungeon, the Lumina questline, and the Truth questline. And in total, the Menagerie had 21 weapons. 7 new weapons from normal and an extra 3 new ones from heroic, the other 21 being from Forsaken. you roughly had 3 weeks to collect all of the weapons, but if I remember correctly, it was much more than that. So this is just 3 weeks. That's from what I remember. We had new emblems and shaders, 4 armor sets, one new set, one from Vanilla D2, and the other 2 being from Forsaken. Each completion of the menagerie was supposed to give 1 reward, but a bug allowed us to get more than 1. Complete customization of what weapon and armor and masterwork to choose from, and the activity itself had 6 different rooms with collectibles and unique mechanics, and a boss room with different mechanics, attacks, and designs. Vanguard had returning armor from Forsaken, new shaders, emblems, and pinnacle weapon. Crucible had returning armor from Forsaken as well, with new shaders, emblem, and pinnacle weapon. Gambit Prime had no new armor, new shaders, emblem, and pinnacle weapon. So when I say that, again, I mean Gambit had literally the same armor since it's been announced, since it's been out. So, yeah. No new faction rallies, no Trials of the Nine. Iron Banner had returning armor from Vanilla D2, returning weapons from Warmind, and new shaders, emblem, and a sparrow. Season of Opulence had a new raid, which had 4 new weapons and 1 new exotic, 1 new armor set, a ghost emblem, and 2 shaders. No new strikes, and that's pretty much it for all of them. So I'm going to be tallying up the totals right now. Now, if you guys want to know my opinions, let me know in the comments below. I'm not going to put my opinions in this video. I'll probably put them in another video, but let's start off with Season of Dawn. So Season of Dawn in total had 2 new story missions, no new planet, 1 new area, 1 new activity, no raid or raid lair, no faction rally, no Trials of the Nine, 6 new exotics, 2 of them being exotic quests, no new strikes, 18 weapons in total, 8 being new and 7 being old weapons, 2 armor sets, 1 being new and the other one from Iron Banner Year 1 and Year 2, 1 armor ornament, and that's pretty much it. If there's anything else that I failed to mention, believe you me, I'm not trying to like downplay this or anything. I just don't remember much of Season of Dawn. I don't remember like all of it, but like I said, if I'm wrong about this, let me know in the comments below. I'll pin it. But the next one we're going to be looking at is Warmind. So for Warmind, in total, we had 3 new story missions, 1 new planet, 1 new activity, 1 new raid lair, faction rallies, Trials of the Nine, 19 exotics, 4 of them being exotic quests with one of them having its own area, 2 new strikes, 3 if we include the PS4 exclusives, 52 weapons, 53 if we include the PS4 exclusives, 19 weapons being reskins and the remaining being new, 3 armor sets, 4 if we include the PS4 exclusives, 2 new ones being from the Mars armor and the Escalation protocol, the Raid armor, which is a reskin, and the 4th one being the PS4 exclusive, and then 8 armor ornaments, Vanguard, Crucible, the Raid Lair, Faction Rallies, Trials of the Nine, and Iron Banner. I'm not even counting the shaders, emblems, ghosts, ships, and sparrows, mostly because aside from the shaders and emblems and exotic emote, most are just legendary reskins aside from the Whisper ship, the 2 exotic sparrows, the exotic ghosts from Trials, and the Crucible and Faction Rally exotic ornaments. And last but not least, we have Season of Opulence, which had no story missions, a new area, 1 new activity, a new raid, no faction rally, no Trials of the Nine, 7 new exotics, 3 of them being exotic quests and 1 of them having its own area, no new strikes, 32 weapons, 11 being new and the 21 being weapons that were already in the game but made easier to farm, and 6 armor sets, 2 being new and the other 4 being from Nessus, Iron Banner Year 1, and 2 from Forsaken. So if you asked me, does Season of Dawn have more content than, let's say, Season of Opulence or Warmind? In my opinion, I would have to say no, mostly because Warmind had so much depth. And you also got to remember that after a month, we were not done. We were still doing the raid. We were still doing Escalation Protocol. We were still doing like stuff. We still had stuff to do, because you got to remember, it wasn't just like, oh, all of this was available. In Warmind, there was a lot of things that was time gated, because that's what they do. That's what they've always done. Same thing with Season of Opulence. Season of Opulence was fun from the very beginning to like, not the very end, I'll grant you that, but it was more than Season of Dawn. So I really don't like it when people tell me, oh, Season of Dawn has more content. I think what you're thinking about is the fact that they're time gating so much stuff, and it's not even like there's no bulk of stuff to do in the beginning of a season. They're time gating stuff that's just very minimalistic, and people think that's content. So in my opinion, if you guys think differently, I mean, by all means, it's your own fucking thought process, but in my opinion, Season of Dawn's just empty. It's really empty. 18 weapons and only 8 of them are new, compared to Season of Opulence, where 32 weapons and 11 of them are new, but 21 were still easier to farm because of Season of Opulence. 52 weapons for Warmind. And I don't care what you think. Weapons is content. You go out to get weapons. You do that for Nightfalls. You like, I'm still trying to farm some world weapons for Season of Dawn. That's content, man. Like, you're still trying to get a weapon. I don't care what you say. This is a looter shooter. And when people are like, nah, guns aren't content. What? Like, it is the. Yeah, that's pretty much my thought process on it. Let me know what you guys think about what this season has to offer. Am I wrong? Probably. You'll probably tell me in the comments below, but let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Other than that, I will see you guys later. Thank you for everyone who's constantly supported me and everything. I really do appreciate it. And like always, I'll see you guys later.